हेलो क्लास 10th. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक एंड दिस इज हेटरोट्रॉफिक न्यूट्रिशन. बिफोर दिस टॉपिक आई टॉट यू अबाउट द ऑटोट्रॉफिक मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन इन विच आई टॉट यू अबाउट प्लांट्स एंड फोटोसिंथेसिस प्रोसेस. राइट, आफ्टर दैट वी विल डिस्कस हेटरोट्रॉफिक न्यूट्रिशन. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट दिस टॉपिक फ्रॉम डेफिनेशन. मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन ऑफ एन ऑर्गेनिज्म गेट फूड फ्रॉम अदर ऑर्गेनिजम्स like plant and animals. Means in this mode of nutrition organism are depend on other organisms for food. These other organisms are plants and animals. Means heterotrophic organisms are taking food from other animals or other plants. Okay, got it now? To obtain the food, these heterotrophic organisms use different kind of strategies, right? And these strategies are depend on some factors. Some factors are here. First one is availability of food. This factor is very important because wherever the food is present, these heterotrophic organisms will be present there for the food. Okay, so the availability of food is very important because to obtain the food, the heterotrophic organism will go there. Okay. Second is about mobility and immobility of food. This is very important factor. Some foods are mobile, can run from one place to another place. Where another kind of food is immobile, like grass. Grass can't move from one place to another place. Right. So cow, which is herbivore animal, will eat grass, and for that the cow having different kind of modification in her body. Okay, like cow's teeth are very much perfect to cut the body of the grass. Okay, and the alimentary canal of any herbivore animal including cow is very much perfect to digest the hardest carbohydrate, cellulose. Okay, so these kinds of modifications are there. If you will see the mobility present into the food, for example, deer is the food of cow, and deer can run from one place to another place. So for the hunting of the deer, when tiger will hunt the deer, then only the tiger can take the food. So for hunting, the different kind of modifications are there in the tiger body, and after that the tiger alimentary canal is very much perfect to digest the body of the prey. Okay, so here these factors are very important, and to obtain the food, including these factors, to obtain the food, the herbivores, the heterotrophic organisms having the different kind of strategies. After the strategies, we will discuss about the different types of heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Right? These are mainly three types: holozoic mode of nutrition, parasitic mode of nutrition, and the saprophytic mode of nutrition. Right? So let's discuss these mode of nutrition in detail. Okay? First of all, we will discuss about the holozoic mode of nutrition. This mode of nutrition is followed by many animals, which you know very well. Like cow, like tiger, like dog, like human, like bear, any familiar organ animal. Okay. In this mode of nutrition, animal use mainly five steps. Okay. First is ingestion of food. Intaking of food into the body is called ingestion. Then after digestion of food, when body will intake the food and food is present inside the body, now the body will digest that. Digestion, the second step. After the digestion, body will absorb the digestive nutrients. That is called absorption, the third step. Fourth is assimilation. Assimilation means utilization of food. The body will utilize these nutrients. And at last, whatever is left, the waste material, whatever is left into the body will excrete that. Okay, so five steps are there. I am repeating it. Ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, and excretion. Got it now? So this is the holozoic type of mode of nutrition. In holozoic mode of nutrition, here you can see herbivore animals are also holozoic type, carnivore and omnivore also. So herbivores are what? Those eat plants or grass are called herbivore. You know very well. Carnivore, those eat the flesh or the body of the prey. Okay. And these carnivores always hunt. They kill the prey first and then after they take the food from their bodies. Okay. After killing them. Yeah. And next is about omnivore. These omnivore are what? Those can eat plant as well as animal. Okay. So here all these three types of animals are comes under holozoic mode of nutrition. After that holozoic mode of nutrition, the second is about the parasites. Parasitic mode of nutrition. Okay. These are of two types, internal parasites and external parasites. If you will see these two diagrams, so these are very familiar for you because these was in the syllabus of class 9th biology, classification of living organism. These are the S.K. helminthes and these are the platyhelminthes. Ascariasis, internal parasites, and platyhelminthes, tapeworm, tinea solium, internal parasites. They are present into the gut of animal and they absorb the digested food from there. Means they don't have the special kind of organ, they don't have to cut or to chew the food. So that's why. And they don't have the special alimentary canal also. So what they do? They just absorb the nutrient from the gut of the animals. Okay. So these are called the internal parasites. Right? Next is external parasite. Mosquito, leech and lice. These all animals you know very well. They are the external because they are not living inside the body. They come from surrounding and they suck the nutrients. Okay, from the animal body. Got it now? These are the examples of some animals. Plants are also some plants are also parasites, like cuscuta. Cuscuta is a type of plant which follow the parasitic mode of nutrition. Means it just absorbs the food from another plants. Okay, it having some spiny tentacles which it penetrate the body of the other plant and from there it just absorbs nutrients. Okay, so this was parasitic mode of nutrition. These depend on host for the nutrition. Okay, but one thing is different from although these are the heterotrophic mode of these are following the heterotrophic mode of nutrition, but then also these will not kill the animal. These will take the food from its body but will not kill it, where carnivores kill the body of the organism. Okay, that is the difference between the carnivore and parasitic mode of nutrition. Got it? After that we will discuss about saprophytic mode of nutrition. Before studying it, you keep one thing in your mind. Fungi you keep in your mind. Okay, fungi follow saprophytic mode of nutrition. So what is the speciality of saprophytic mode of nutrition? Saprophytes digest food out of the body. First they digest the body and then after they absorb digested nutrients. Okay, how they do that work, that you just understand now. It's a microscopic structure of fungi, bran mold. Okay, here you can see rhizoids, stolon part, hyphae, sporangium, and in the sporangium spore formation takes place, and here you can see spores are spreading out after bursting of sporangium. So this is the microscopic structure of that. You just notice in the diagram these fiber like structures are called hyphae. These hyphae produce some digested solution, digested juices which can digest the food. So it just secrete these digestive solution from here, and that digestive solution having many enzymes, and these enzymes digest the food. After digestion of the food out of the body, the fungi absorb that absorb nutrition from there. Okay, so here what is happening? Digestion takes place out of the body first and then after the fungi body absorb nutrients from there. Okay, so ingestion process and excretion process will not take place here. Digestion takes place out of the body in saprophytic mode of nutrition. Then they absorb the solution, okay, and they utilize that. So ingestion or excretion is not here. Okay, so sometime in board exam the question can come, write the difference between the holozoic mode of nutrition and this saprophytic mode of nutrition. Then what you will write here? Ingestion takes place, internal digestion. Digestion takes place inside the body, but in the saprophytic mode of nutrition, where the digestion takes place? Out of the body. Okay, so that is the difference between these two. After this, we will study symbiosis, another kind of mode of nutrition. Actually, symbiosis is not only the mode of nutrition, it's a living style. Here in symbiosis, two different type of living organism come together, okay, and they live together, provide the benefit to each other. In symbiosis, I am taking the example of lichen. Okay, in your syllabus, lichen is given. So, lichen is what? Lichen is the association of algae and fungi. Okay, so here these green ball like structures are what? Algal part, algae part of the lichen, which is called phycobiont part. Algal part is called the phycobiont part of lichen. Okay, where the black thread like structures are what? Fungi. Okay, and this fungi is called mycobiont part. Mycobiont part of lichen is formed by fungi. Okay, so here you can see the association of algae and fungi. Both are different species living together and providing benefit to each other. What these benefits are? Let's discuss about the fungi. Fungi having the great power of absorption that I taught you here. Okay, they having the great power of absorption. But what is the speciality of algae? Algae is autotrophic, can synthesize its own food. So here the fungi providing the raw material to the algae, and these fungi absorb these raw material from surrounding. These fungi provide that raw material to the algae, and with the help of raw material, the algae synthesizes food in presence of sunlight. Okay, so here both are living together. Algae is providing food to the fungi, and fungi is providing shelter as well as raw material for the preparation of food to the algae. Okay, so this is called symbiosis. Symbiosis definition is what? What is symbiosis association? When two different species come together and provide benefit to each other, that living association is known as symbiosis.